This is Mike Reynolds Year in Review.
Folks, I gotta tell you, this is the proudest day of my life.
1985 was one of those years when I just kept bumping into interesting people.
Hey, what do you think of my new duds, huh?
Drive.
This year we got to meet Buffalo's Rambo, Buffalo's Pee-wee Herman, and Buffalo's burger-eating machine, The Butcher. Where else but in Western New York would I be able to interview a kid who can take off his face, a couple of skunk busters, a man who walks for a living, a chimp that ice skates, some dolphins, and two ladies who really didn't mind being called dogs. 1985, it was the best of times and the worst of times. It had its rotten moments. And it's memorable one. It was a year that I walked the thin line between the ridiculous and the sublime, and maybe along the way even learned a few new tricks. One thing's for sure, I didn't set any new fashion trends this year, although it certainly isn't because I didn't try. Did I prove that I have absolutely no sense of fashion, but 1985 was the year that I explored some unusual modes of transportation. By kite, by tube, by dog sled, by Batmobile, by shopping cart, by police escort, by $90,000 car, by rug, by Cabbage Patch doll, and sometimes, though it wasn't planned, even by foot. Though 1985 may have brought with it a few headaches, look on the bright side. Beginning tomorrow, we all get to start from scratch. This is Mike Randall for Eyewitness News.